Electricity going through the brain tissue, even when it has to pass through the skull.
The high voltage easily travels from the skull into the brain. But how does this current kill? Does it cook the brain, or does it short it out?
There is a myth that exists that when a person is electrocuted in a legal electrocution, that their body is going to heat up to a boiling temperature and that their eyeballs are going to explode and all these terrible things are going to happen. So I'm going to take a hot dog, and I have to warn you that what I'm doing is dangerous. I would actually characterize it as stupid. Do not try this at home. I'm going to put one end of a nail into one end of the hot dog. I'm going to put the other end of the nail into the other end of the hot dog, push it in a little bit to make some good contact. Okay, here we go. There we go. And you'll notice that there's not a lot happening. This would be very much like a legal electrocution in the sense that the body itself isn't going to heat up massively. Okay, at this point, we're starting to hear the effects of heating in the hot dog.
It takes nearly 1 minute for signs of heat to appear on the hot dog. This is more than double the time of the electric cycle during an execution.
So I'm going to unplug this. I'm going to see if we can get a temperature on the hot dog. The reading would be just a little over 106 degrees. Now, that would be consistent with what we know about legal electrocution. And if I pick this up, it is warm to the touch, but it's not exceptionally hot.
A rapid rise in body temperature is not enough to quickly kill a healthy adult. So just how does a person die when sentenced to the electric chair?
Basically, every electrical cell in your body is going to what we call depolarize, and that basically means fire and do its job.
Say you have one neuron in your brain that's responsible for you breathing in. You have another neuron in your brain that's responsible for you breathing out. You stimulate both of those at the same time, your body can't breathe in and out. Same thing for your heart beating, same thing for any system in your body. When you're firing all of those neurons at once, you're completely overloading your system.
So the electric chair kills by completely overwhelming and confusing the human body. The brain effectively shorts out, and eventually the heart stops beating. During a legal electrocution, the jolt delivers two cycles of electricity. The high voltage of the first cycle takes out the brain and nervous system.
This is going to be the nerves going to his brain, the nerves going to his heart, the nerves going to his arm, to his bowels, to his mouth.
It usually results in permanent brain death, but it might not be enough to stop the heart, which can continue beating.
Their muscles will still contract, their face will contort.
The on-site medical examiner can only pronounce death upon cessation of the heart. This is why the second cycle has lower voltage and lower amperage. This causes the heart to fibrillate, throwing the muscles out of rhythm and induces a heart attack.
Some people may die immediately due to cardiac arrest, and others may suffer a little longer until eventually their heart or their brain does give out.
Probably as our society has evolved, it certainly does not have the appeal that perhaps it had 100 years ago. The difference, I think, is that maybe the definition of what is cruel and unusual has changed.
Today, most states have abandoned the electric chair as they search for more humane methods of capital punishment. But electricity has pushed society forward in countless ways. The technology of the modern era definitely advanced the engineering of execution equipment. In an attempt to create more humane death devices, machine builders mechanized old techniques borrowed from the military and exploited a power phenomenon. But now, these mechanisms are viewed as some of history's most malicious machines.
接下来，你知道木材运输、 赛车与真空动力之间有何关联吗？答案就在搞怪实验室接着播出。